From the moment I saw you, deep inside my heart I knew. Baby, you're my destiny. You and I were meant to be. With all my heart and soul,
I give my love to heaven home.
And as far as I can see, you were always meant to be my destiny. Ooh. I wanted someone like you, someone that I could hold on to and give my love until the end of time.
Forever, I believe.
Baby, you're
Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Family, dear friends, we are gathered in the sight of God in the presence of this company to join this man and this woman in the bonds of holy marriage, which is an honorable estate instituted by God when he said, a man shall leave his father and his mother, and they shall cleave, and they shall cleave to his wife, and they shall be one flesh. It not ought to therefore be entered into lightly or hastily, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Joseph Allen Holtz and Kristin Dawn Vanderven have come to be joined into this holy estate. Let us pray for this journey and their commitment today. Heavenly Father, we come before you today. We gather in your house, and we thank you because you are the author of love. You have shown us love. You have shown us how to love when you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us. You showed us love over and over again, Lord, when we make mistakes as your children and you forgive us. Lord, we come today to witness a demonstration of your love. As Joe and Kristin come before you today to give themselves to one another in a sacrificial love, what they have learned in their journey in life from you. Lord, may they be bound by your love and by your Holy Spirit. And we commit them to you today. In your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. You've chosen two passages of Scripture, first from Matthew chapter 19, verses 4 through 6. Haven't you read, he replied, that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female, and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore what God has joined together, let man not separate. And then from Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 through 7. I thank my God every time I remember you in all my prayers for all of you. I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on completion until the day of Christ. I remember not that long ago there was a strange man who came to worship, and he'd sit with Kristin and her mom and Nick. The man would come, he'd always be wearing a ball cap. But he not only came to worship, but regularly he started attending other events. And we discovered this strange man hanging around had a name, and it was Joe. Joe not only had a name, but he has a voice. And as time went on, we got to know Joe and even had the opportunity to walk with him through some hard and difficult times. Today, that strange man named Joe and Kristin are expressing their love for one another and their love for God. The two scriptures that you have chosen deal with being united and being in partnership. And they're very fitting for what the two of you are to embark upon today. The passage in Matthew speaks about leaving your parents and being united to one another. Now, I know how much you both are connected to your parents and to your mothers, and how this passage talking about leaving is not easy for the two of you. The two of you will be united as one, and so the two of you will now have to take care of each other's parents. You must be unified in who you are and what you do. You are both children of God, and what you do is love God and love others. Sounds so simple. And it is. If you can remember what Paul said in the beginning, the Creator, which we all know is God, made male and female. So what you are doing is bringing together what God created the two of you to be. One in heart, soul, mind, and strength. Love and support one another as God has taught us in his word. Paul, in the Philippians verses, speaks about being a partner in sharing the gospel. He also speaks about how he prays with joy over the partnership which comes from God working in their lives. The partnership that you are acknowledging today and joining in comes from God working in your lives. Just as Paul placed his heart, those who partnered in sharing the gospel with him, so too must you each place each other's heart as you live and labor for the Lord. Paul cares deeply about those who are serving with him in the name of the Lord, and the two of you must care deeply about each other. Keep each other close to the heart, for it's the heart where we find Jesus and that love which is sacrificial and unending. May that love that you have for each other be that type of love. This union is a bonding of two people by God, and God is the one who's shown us how to love and be bound as one. Jesus came to earth to live and die for the bride of the church, and we all know we have to have that same love and commitment. Love God and love each other is the sequence that we hold the two of you together till death do you part. You've heard all about what you need to do, and now what you need to do is up to you. You need to daily put it into practice. Some days will be easy, other days it'll be a challenge. But remember, it will always be rewarding. So I got something for the two of you to remind you of this day. I have bought you a lottery ticket, and you can win up to $50,000. Now, you have two options. The first option, very obvious, we all know, is you can gamble and you can scratch it off and see what you win. The other option I'm going to challenge you with and give you is to take this and use it for a bookmark in your Bible to remind you of this day and your commitment to God and one another and how rich you are because you have each other. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for Joe and Kristin and for their coming together, for their willingness to have and to hold and take one another. In the midst of their flaws and humanness, Lord, in spite of our imperfections, Lord, we love as you love. And so, Lord, may that love be deep, deep in their hearts. And may it grow, Lord. May your Holy Spirit water that love, and may it grow daily, Lord, as they spend time together with one another, time with family and friends, but most importantly, time with you, God. So bless them on this journey. In your name we pray. Amen. I charge you each and both, as you shall answer to him before whom the secrets of all hearts are open, that if either of you know any reason why you may not lawfully be joined in marriage, declare it now. Let us pray. Lord, this is the time when they're going to make and take vows to one another. Lord, may they speak from their hearts to each other. May it come with all sincerity, clarity and truth. Help them, Lord, because as all of us who enter into marriage know, to be faithful from this day on and keep the promises that we make, we need your help. We need your guidance. We need your Holy Spirit to direct our lives. Lord, keep them bound with your Spirit so that they might experience the glory of being united as one and the glory of serving and living for you. Lord, we pray this all through Jesus' name. Amen. Did you, Joseph Allen Holtz, take Kristin Dawn Vannervan before God and these witnesses to be your wedded wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, forsaking every other, keep to her only so long as you both shall live? You, Kristin Dawn Vannervan, take Joseph Allen Holtz before God and these witnesses to be your wedded husband. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, forsaking every other, keep to him only, so so long as you both shall live. Joe, repeat after me. I, Joe, take you, Kristin, as my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance. Thereto I pledge myself, truly with all my heart. Repeat after me, Kristin. I, Kristin, take you, Joe, as my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge myself, truly with all my heart. So what token do you give of your marriage vows? These rings are a fitting symbol of the commitment they are making today, because these rings have no beginning and they have no ending. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. With this ring, I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. With this ring, I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
When the
Dear Lord, we come to you and thank you again. This whole time, our focus has been on you and love and the love that you've placed in Joe and Kristen's heart. Lord, what a joy it is to witness love, to be part of love. Lord, be with Joe and Kristen today who acknowledge their love for each other. We thank you that you have given them the opportunity to find love, faith, and trust in each other. That they come before us today willing to take each other to have and hold all the days of their life. Lord, we ask that nothing come between them. Through all the chances of changes of life, keep them forever loving and true. Keep them safe from illness, from poverty, from all trouble which would hurt them and harm them in any way. But Lord, when trials do come, may they be drawn closer to each other and closer to you. Lord, thank you that you have ordained this day, that you are here and we experience your presence. And Lord, we now pray over them and send them out to live, to laugh, and to love in your care now and forevermore. Amen. This is going to be interesting because I noticed how precise the two of you were at making sure you poured half of it. So there is going to be some interesting times ahead as we figure out who's exactly right. And for as much as you, Joe, and Kristen had covenanted together, according to God's holy ordinance of marriage, you've confirmed the same by making solemn vows before God in this company. By giving and receiving a ring, I pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and you may kiss your bride. As the scripture said, what God has joined together, let no one seek to pull apart. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with both of you and all of us, now and forever. Amen. It is my privilege and my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joseph and Kristin Holtz.
These times of trouble, and these times are good, and they're always gonna be. They rise and they fall. We take them all the way that we should, together you and me, forsaking them all. True love always does. And here by your side, we're a million miles away. Nothing's ever gonna change the way I feel. The way it is the way that it was. When I said I do, I meant that I will. Till the end of
more
than a woman and a man. And after spot here alone in our dreams. I know there's a lonely heart in every lost and found, but forever you and I will be the ones who found out what forever means. When I said I do,
river flows surely to the sea.